Here in California, homeowners are faced with yet another challenge as State Farm announced last month it will not renew more than 70,000 policies.
So that includes areas in our county like Rancho Santa Fe, El Cajon, Lakeside, and University Heights. So let's talk about this. Joining us now to get some insight on the impact is former San Diego City Councilman Scott Sherman, who's also the former president of the San Diego Insurance Brokers Association. Thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
All right, so you have been working in insurance for a long time.
34 years.
Yeah. Tell us what you're seeing out there and why a company like State Farm would just say, nope.
We're seeing, it's not just State Farm, it's across the board. I mean, all those companies are now either not writing or leaving California. And there's a lot of issues with inflation and cost of doing business. But at the end of the day, the real problem is politics has actually gotten involved in this.
How so?
Well, during COVID, the insurance commissioner who wanted to try and bring money back to policyholders mandated and told the insurance companies that you have to give rebates to your policyholders because they were making a lot of money. Everybody was locked up, no claims. The insurance community didn't like that. Some did the rebates, some didn't. The insurance commissioner got mad, wouldn't let them take small incremental increases in premium over the last 3 or 4 years. So on an average year, a company makes about 5 cents on the dollar, an insurance company. Mm-hmm. Now they're spending about $1.15 for every dollar they bring in. And they said, well, if you won't let us take rate, we're just going to quit writing or leave the state. And that's usually what's happening.
And renewals are different from cancellations. So explain to people what that means.
You're getting non-renewed. So it's like for no fault of your own. You're just getting a non-renewal notice because we no longer write that type of business. Cancellation usually has a more negative connotation to it. You did something wrong, you have a loss history, something that made them cancel you. Non-renewal is just, we're not doing it.
But in the interim, those people will still be covered until that policy comes to an end.
Until that policy comes to an end. Problem is, you have to shop in a market, you know, for a new policy in a marketplace that is incredibly restricted. Meaning premiums are through the roof compared to what they were with these companies who are still writing, because they used to be the company of last resort, and now they're the company of first resort.
So you were in politics for quite a few years here in San Diego. When you have a group of people, thousands of people who find themselves in a pickle, if you will, they don't know what to do. They can't afford necessarily to get insurance. What do they do? Is the state going to do something to help out here? What can be done?
The state is talking about doing, finally talking about doing some regulation reform and making it easier to get smaller rate increases for some of these companies. Right now, in the interim, it's just very, very difficult and very, very expensive. There is the California Fair Plan, which is, you know, last resort. It's very bare bones coverage, takes forever to get quotes out of them, and usually their premiums are kind of confiscatory. I mean, I've seen large premiums out of the Fair Plan that where you wouldn't expect it in the past.
And you have some personal experience with this because you said this involves apartments too, right?
Oh yeah, it's across the board.
Okay, so it's across the board, and you said that you tell us about just the spike in costs, because it's hard to wrap your brain around how much it's gone up for an apartment complex that is it that you run or own.
It's actually one that's a client of mine and that I insure. It's they're up in Fallbrook, which is a fire zone. We all know it's kind of dangerous up there. Their premium last year with an admitted carrier was a little over $19,000. This year, because there's nobody writing except one or two companies up there, the best quote I can find them is $109,000. The California Fair Plan came in with a quote of $174,000.
And who can afford that?
Nobody. And you can't pass that cost on to the renters. They'd all leave.
So, and we're looking at this fire video. So we live in fire. I mean, that's all of California, fire-prone
it
country
is now,
now. And we just saw here in January, flood-prone country now. So climate change, obviously an issue. And we're seeing the cost, as you mentioned, inflation to rebuild going up. So what do? We can't move somewhere.
Right. I mean, you can, but it makes it very, very difficult. Right now, it's pretty much shop where you can talk to different agencies if you can to find coverage out there. In the end, I think this is going to come back around with some regulation changes and make it a little bit easier for insurance companies to do business. At the end of the day, though, I think the long-term solution is you go back to an appointed insurance commissioner. So the person in charge actually knows something about insurance. Our current insurance commissioner, his degree is in journalism. And no offense to you all, I don't think you could come in and run an insurance industry much like I couldn't come in and tell you how to run a newsroom.
Well, the irony here is you were in politics. You want politics out.
Out, yeah. It's made a mess of it.
Right. What does it mean for housing? Because we kind of saw the story before you came on here where, you know, it's already difficult to buy a house right now with so many costs. Rates are high, and now you add this. How does this affect mortgages in the housing industry?
And property taxes, too.
Property taxes, everything else along the line. One of the dirty little secrets is the state actually makes a little bit more money now on this market because you have to go to surplus lines companies. Surplus lines companies have to pay a California surplus lines tax, and their premiums are very high. But I've seen it now where real estate deals are falling apart because with these new insurance premiums, it just doesn't pencil and they just can't afford it anymore.
We do have a full screen, I think, showing the area specifically affected with State Farm not renewing these policies. So all these folks have to find new policies.
Yeah, and this is just one of a bunch. Mercury and a whole bunch of other companies are just not doing it, or they're limited to, okay, you can have one a month, and that's what they'll do.
And real quickly, how soon do you think that any kind of corrective measure could be taken?
The governor did a emergency declaration directing the insurance commissioner to make some changes. They were talking maybe by the end of the year.
Okay.
And then that will take a while to get implemented, and it'll be a while, but there may be a bright side on the horizon. And I've seen this before where companies have left California. Mm-hmm. Some changes happened. We got more competitive. They all came flooding back in, and premiums went right back down.
Okay. Something's got to give at some point here.
Let's hope for that scenario.
Right. Yeah. Insurance expert, former Councilman Scott Sherman, thank you so much. Appreciate
My pleasure.
The insight.
Thank you.
Yeah, very interesting.
Yeah.